But it's so, you can only understand the entire system once you go to the courts and you say how difficult it is for you to get justice in this country.
Yes.
People who are rich and powerful can engage the best of the lawyers. They succeed in derailing the entire trial for decades and decades, whether it's in the High Court or in the Supreme Court. The only time the lawyers are available is when the clients are behind bars.
Yes.
And it has happened in our case. And otherwise, the appeals can take years and years.
It's difficult.
It's very difficult.
Neelam Kataria would also like to say something to Shabana.
What Mrs. Kataria is saying. Utopia. In India, they don't ostracize the criminal. They vote him into power and he'll be sitting in the parliament or he'll be sitting in the legislative assembly.
I completely agree with what
so
Mrs. Kataria is saying.
That situations in countries.
She's responding to you.
It's a very utopic idea that, okay, let's ostracize, let's create a society where, you know, we can ostracize. All these things probably happen in very, very, I would not say, you know, literate or civilized societies where you're talking about, countries abroad where these things happen, or even chemical castration as far as I see. But ask the victim and their family what they go through when they're fighting for justice in this country where you've got politicians who've been charged with murder or rape or somewhere and getting tickets and coming into power. Where does the common man go and fight in cases like this? It's very easy to say, let's create a society where we can ostracize this person. That's not going to happen. That man is going to go into his daily, get bail, start his work again and do and live a normal life again.
Ravina, two responses coming to you. I'd like to go back to Shabana Azmi because she made the first point there about, let's get a response from Shabana Azmi first, because Ms. Azmi, the response coming from three or four of our panelists is to your suggestion. They're saying ostracizing a person or create waiting for the criminal justice system to reach a point in our country where there is speedy justice is not going to happen overnight. And Shabana Azmi, I'd like to point out a statistic to you. Every 15 to 20 minutes in India, one woman gets raped. And one out of every three people who get raped, most unfortunately, I would like to add, is a young child. The statistics are so shocking. I'm not sure if the country has the patience to wait for that change to happen. But Shabana Azmi, would you like to respond to all the points made, especially the last response by Ravina Tandon? Then I'm coming to the other panelists.
I completely understand the anguish of the families who have been asking for justice and not getting it. I am completely cognizant of the fact that there is this desire and this outrage and this hurt and this bewilderment at the fact that the justice system doesn't work. But because of that, we can't take an action which is even more detrimental. What we have to ask for is speedy justice, and it is possible. Why are we giving it up? Why don't we take this horrific incident as a wake-up call where we say there should be a social audit of the police? We have to have an independent agency like the CAG that can come up and see what is happening to police performances. What are we doing about changing the mindset of those people and what happens in court? There are ways of doing this. I am not at all lessening the complete anguish of the people who suffer from this.
Ms. Azmi, may I just say one thing? That if a person feels I'm going to be set free after a few months or maximum a couple of years, he will feel even more confident to commit the crime over and over again.
But
he becomes a threat to the social fabric of our country.
I am saying certainty of punishment. Certainty of punishment and a speedy.
Where is the certainty in India, Ms. Azmi? Ms. Azmi, today. Today, where is the certainty in our criminal justice system? You know, everybody cannot employ good lawyers to fight for justice. And even if you do, nobody better than Ram Jethmalani knows today that there is no certainty of justice.
And moreover,
in these cases,
the victims are at the mercy of the state.
Yes, exactly.
They cannot afford Ram Jethmalani. They'll all have to do away with whoever the public prosecutor is appointed by the state. I'm sorry. Which will be a no match to Mr. Jethmalani.
Sudhir Tailang, on the point of chemical castration as well.
I'll come to that point also. But I want to completely support Ravina Tandon, what she said. And I was just reading about a story about one single mother in Calcutta who was raped a few months back.
Yeah.
Now, the man who raped her is at large. And this woman has been completely ostracized by the society. She can't go out of the home. She is made lewd comments by people when she goes out on the street. So it is the victim who suffers the most rather than the one who perpetrates the crime in this country. About the castration of the, I think I would say.
Castration is an option.
I would say that.
Your problem is, and let me agree
completely with you, Arnav, that both death penalty and castration are very good options. And I think I'll go in for both of these things. What has happened to this country is that politicians have become completely intolerant. But we have, people are very, very patient. We have waited for 65 years. See, last time when complete frustration, anger found an expression was when Anna Hazare came into the scene.
Yeah.
And this is the same thing has happened. We were waiting for so many, this law and order situation in the country is so bad that today after this incident, Every right-thinking citizen has come out on the street. I just want to understand why Neeraj Kishan Kolhatkar and everyone in, we haven't got two of our panelists in yet, so I'd like to go to Dr. Zehra.
Do you support chemical castration? I want to push the issue of chemical castration. Do you support Dr. Modi's castration?
Yes, of course, as one of the deterrents, but I'd just like to tell you about the situation now reminds me of a Shakespearean play where Titus Andronicus, it's called Titus Andronicus, the Titus is the father, his daughter is raped, and he kills his daughter because he says she is the culprit. The daughter is the culprit. I think we all are playing Titus here in our society. At present, the entire scenario is that we are having a package. Arnav, we are having a package of agony, anger, as well as we are ashamed. So this package is very dangerous for our society, and we need to look at a strong deterrent.
I want to be very focused on this deterrent. And I want to ask Mr. Jethpalani. Mr. Kaul, I'm very sorry for coming to you late, but Mr. Jethpalani wants to intervene, then I'm coming to you. Mr. Jethpalani, okay, you don't want the death penalty, but why not chemical castration? And why I'm saying chemical castration is because you tell any potential rapist that if you're caught and you're convicted, you'll be sure you're going to be castrated.
Damn for life.
Then there will be a great, you know, just for fear, out of fear, plus social taboo, the person will never think of rape. Why can't we think about it? Why do we get so nervous when we talk about castration as an option?
I am not nervous about castration at all. I have only one reservation to make, that castration is quite a penalty which ought to be considered seriously by the legislature. And I have one reservation, and that it should be for a confirmed rapist, like a person who commits the rape a second time in his life, or that there is evidence of a psychiatrist or a medical man to say that this man is a rapist by convictions of his own genes or otherwise, and therefore there is no question of his ever being subjected to any reformation by punishment, then castration is a proper remedy to inflict upon such a person.
I'm with you,
Arnav, I have not got an answer to my basic question yet.
I think, Ravina, just coming to you, I want to get Neeraj Kishan call in.
Is Mr. Ram Jethpalani saying that the first time round rape is not as bad as it is the second time? Is that what he's saying?
Okay.
I'm not saying that at all, but I'm talking of the utility of castration as a remedy. I believe that it should be for those who are not capable of ever being reformed. There is a reformative theory of justice which we can't forget just because we are angry at the moment.
No, so Mr. Jethpalani, in this case, the person is not a serial offender. In this case, the main accused is not a serial offender. How does your logic apply in this case?
I'm sure that he is not. Somebody has to investigate his antecedents. You will find that from the nature of the offense, I believe that this man must be a confirmed rascal.
No, but one second. I don't understand again your argument, Mr. Jethpalani, that if somebody carries out one and a first rape, if this incident vis-a-vis this girl was this person's first offense, then he is not deserving of castration. Unless he has carried out two rapes, then it would be seen as an incentive for a person to carry out one rape. Mr. Jethpalani.
Arnav, I can't get into, you know, subtle distinctions about situations, but I am laying down a principle, a question of principle. The question of principle is that you must be convinced that deterrence of punishment will not reform this person.
Mr. Jethpalani, I would like to debate with you on this, and my point is, let us... Shabana Azmi is responding to you, Mr. Jethpalani. You're getting a response. Shabana Azmi, go ahead. Shabana responding, and I don't think Shabana Azmi is responding in anger alone. Yes, Ms. Azmi, to Mr. Jethwalani.
No, I find this a very strange argument that the first time around the person should be allowed to go through reform, and only if he commits a rape the second time, which gives him a leeway to do it the second time. But the point that I want to ask is, who is going to do this castration? This chemical castration is going to be done by which agency? We have lost faith in every single agency. We have lost faith in the police. We have lost faith in the justice system. We have lost faith in society. Who is going to carry out this chemical castration that we are asking for?
Doctors will do it.
Who is going to do it?
Okay, Neeraj Kishan, call. Neeraj Kishan, call. The question is being asked by Shabana Azmi. Who is going to carry out chemical castration? First of all, I would like your views on chemical castration. Very seriously, your views on the death penalty, and whether you think Shabana Azmi's question here has merit. Who is going to carry out chemical castration anyway? Mr. Kaul.
Arnab, the answer doesn't lie in sweeping changes in the law. The answer lies in better administering of the system. If you see the statistics from 1973, there's been a major decline in convictions in rape cases. So you can have any penalty that you like, whether it's castration, whether it's death penalty, but if you've got to have shoddy investigations, weak charge sheets, and no convictions, what penalty will you impose on the person concerned?
Correct.
So the first thing that you must look at, is proper investigations, strong charge sheets, speedy trials, and convictions.
Really?
And that's what matters.
Sure.
You know, we are completely missing the point.
Tell me, Mr. Kaul, will the system change overnight?
No, will the system change overnight?
Now
let me answer that. So by imposing death penalty, and if you still can't convict the person, will you achieve what you want to achieve?
Correct.
That's exactly the point, Arnav, that today when we are all disgusted, just a minute, now hear me out. Today we are all disgusted with what has happened. This happens every day in some part of the country. It is appalling, it's abhorring, we all agree with it. But the fact is how to go about it. Death penalty, castration are matters of larger debates. Please debate. They may be part of a solution ultimately. But if you do not administer and bring the guilty to book, no penalty will be of any use. And let me tell you as a lawyer,
Just listen. But Mr. Kaul, let me share a shocking statistic with you. Between 1971 and 2011, there must have been 1,000 seminars, 1,000,000 workshops, 1,000 social activists, and I can assure you 10,000 papers at least sponsored by the government of India on how to improve the criminal justice system. The people, the number of do-gooders in our society does not go down. But in this 40-year period, 873% jump in the number of cases of rape.
Right. So will the answer...
873%
yes, exactly,
jump. I want Ravina Tandon to respond
is,
right now to Neeraj Kishan call and then get other panelists.
Yes, but
Ravina
is the answer...
Patience is what
Arnab,
we are being
is the answer
for.
In changing...
You know, Arnab, honestly,
for the system
honestly,
to change.
No, is the answer... Just a minute. Can I complete?
Years,
the
like
answer, tell
me,
without change...
Where here we are trying to...
Without changing the system...
And talking about the girl child, and then we have no law which is strong enough to either deter or punish those kind of people who torture or mutilate or rape our daughters. So something like
howsoever strong a law you may howsoever
is,
strong a law you may
is,
have
is a very
if you do not
idea.
Have a system of convicting the accused if you don't have a system of convicting the accused you can have the strongest law, it's of no use at all. You can have the strongest punishment that is available known to the criminal
but
justice
I think
system,
that is why
but if you cannot convict a person what's the use of
today.
The law
but the problem this, if this fire has started today it's not because of today, it's been simmering and boiling since a long time where it has
yes.
reached this point where
so
today
immediate,
there are protests
what are the immediate
country.
Requirements
obviously it is
the
because
immediate
we are
requirements
frustrated
are,
to a certain degree about the way the system is being administered
course,
at the moment because nothing seems to work
absolutely
so that is
so
the reason why
that answers
all,
the question
the
carry out the
castration.
That answers the question that requires an improvement of the system
who is going to carry out the castration, then
we'll see who's going to carry out.
We'll see means what? There will be some system.
May I please attempt?
One second. You say...
Shabana Azmi, may I please attempt here? Usually what is happening in the countries where chemical castration has been looked at, including the United States of America,